It's over. It's all over. Go ahead, put down your guns, cease fire. Pretty much the war is over. Activision and Infinity Ward have pretty much said, you know what? We're waving the white flag. We give up. We give up. What happened, you say? What happened? Well, for the first time ever, Activision has announced that they're going to be doing a free multiplayer open week, basically. So they're going to go ahead and let people on the 360, the Xbox One, I think it might have been only those two consoles, maybe the PC, they're going to let you play Call of Duty Ghosts for free. Now, it's not going to be the full game. It's almost going to be set up kind of like a beta. You're going to have about three maps you can play, three different map modes or game modes, and really just going to give you be able to get your hands on it. And the big thing is, one, you're going to ask, why are they doing this? I mean, they've never done anything like this ever. Why do it now? And the big thing is, they're hurting. They know they're hurting. I had put out videos before Ghost ever came out calling that this game was going to be a flop just because they weren't listening to the community. It was almost like, we know how to make video games. We don't need your input, which I can see that to a certain extent, you know, but you got to listen to them at least, you know, you got to get their input. Otherwise, you're just going to be, it's going to be worthless. And that's kind of what happened. You know, they completely avoided the entire competitive side of things. And then afterwards, they try to do a last second, well, okay, here, we'll give you some stuff. And it's just like, it's too little too late, you know, and they just completely avoid what makes the game or made Call of Duty Call of Duty, and they try to combine it and bring in new things, which, you know what, I'll give you, it takes moxie, it takes balls to be able to go ahead and attempt to do that. But in the same aspect, you almost have to have a contingency plan, a plan of, okay, if this doesn't work out, what can I do now, you know? And they don't. They didn't have, you know, a good map pack where you could get a bunch of small maps in or something like that along those lines. It's losing people year by year. And it's, like I said before, when everybody comes out, when the new game comes out, everybody always asks one question. Is this the Call of Duty killer? And just the fact that we're always asking that question means that we're looking for an answer. We're looking for something that's going to replace it. And I feel like, especially from the FPS community, I feel like a lot of us are thinking we might not have it, but we have a couple of really good games that are coming down to the wire here that are going to be game changers. You know, between one, Destiny, is a lot of people are looking forward to Destiny. It's made by the same people who made Halo. And the game itself is supposed to revolutionize the way you play modern warfare. It's supposed to be like a RPG, MMO type thing into it. And it's supposed to really change the look at things. And then you have another game like Titanfall, which is still kind of your typical FPS leveling up. They pretty much announced now that they're going to have a prestige type. They're going to call it Generation, I do believe. But it's going to be basically your Call of Duty same system, because this is made from the people from Modern Warfare. But it's going to be more futuristic, bringing in a little bit more, I don't want to say unrealistic type things, but more future technologies. It's almost to the Halo extent, because you're able to wall jump, you can run on the walls, you can like cling onto the walls, you're able to do a lot of that stuff. And I think the community is ready for it, just because it's, when you play Call of Duty at one point in time, you get to the point where you're no longer watching or playing the game in a complete total real world aspect. And the main thing I mean by this is, you don't play the game so vertically. You're playing strictly horizontal, you're looking straight down your sights. You might have to check up, you know, one, maybe two levels at most in Call of Duty. Now, there are a couple of them where they tried to integrate some more verticality in Call of Duty Ghosts, but, you know, when it's not been part of the game, it just makes the game kind of clunky, because it makes it very difficult to be able to get up to those high heights. And with this one, you can pretty much just jump up there, do a couple wall jumps, you're up there, you're able to get to this place as quickly. And it is a player, you look at the world differently. Instead of how to getting from point A to point B, I have to go down these roads, you select stairs and windows. There's only a finite number of ways or possibilities to do that. To go into having it now where the world is your oyster, basically, you can get however you want to places. And I think that's what's going to be really unique and really start to separate a lot of players as far as from the creativity kind of side of things, because you could be so much more creative in Titanfall than you could be in Call of Duty. And for a while there were some creative things that people were doing in Call of Duty, but it's only a matter of time before someone's uniqueness becomes, you know, the norm. I mean, look at such things as the drop shot. When Modern Warfare was out, you see very select few people do the drop shot, and it was something that, you know, only like the top level people did, and that's where you, oh, you damn drop shotter and all this kind of stuff. And then you started seeing people do a little bit more of the jump shots and everything like that. And you could just see that the skill level of the average person, the average player, was rising. And I think we're going to see the same thing with Titanfall, but guys, I think that Titanfall is going to have a higher plateau than Call of Duty. Now, so the big question is, how does this all kind of relate to Call of Duty bringing out this multiplayer free play, basically? And it's all about timing. I mean, they couldn't have picked that they're going to do this the week before Titanfall releases. And I think that they understand that this isn't something like a GTA 5 in Call of Duty player base is not really the same player base. If you look at the Venn diagram, of course they're going to overlap a little bit, but it's not going to be a huge section of your player base, your hardcore player base, the people who are still playing the game now that's been out for 5 months, that player base, it's not going to be that big of an overlapping group. So Titanfall, though, is going to be geared towards your first-person shooters. It's really trying to grab that same core group of players as Battlefield, Call of Duty, and now Titanfall. So I think that after as well as that beta went, I mean, I don't think I heard anybody who was talking about the Titanfall beta that was not excited about the game. I don't see here anybody who was complaining about anything about the game. It was just raving reviews, and that's complete opposite that you've seen for Call of Duty. And I think this, it has to have them scared as far as we're going to lose our market control. Now, the big question is, one thing that Call of Duty does have is that they're getting away from their every other year release cycle, and they're gonna, you know, give people a little bit more time to build the games. And I think that's what they need to do, because when you take that extra time to polish the game, it really makes the big difference of being able to get rid of some things, add some uniqueness, add things that you're only going to find by putting just time into the game. And that's it. Let me know what you guys think about this whole situation. Make sure you guys leave it in the comment section down below. Make sure you guys hit that like button, hit subscribe, and I'll see you guys later. Spotlight, make sure you guys go ahead and check it out. This is a video that I put out back in November where I pretty much talked about the end of an era.